hi there, pipe. Pipe tubers. Jay, this is for your contest, Close Calls. As you saw at the beginning of the clip, I was showing also latest acquisition, which is this Mario Grandi sort of squat Dublin, as they called it. Inexpensive pipe. Another good example that you don't have to spend a lot of money to get something that looks and smokes quite nice. Including post, this was about 30 something pounds. It's got quite a neat little inlay on the shank. Nice, perfect 80s pipes, sandblast black. Great, I just filled it with some Boswell's, or which one was it? I think it's Maple Leaf. Again, courtesy of Jason, thanks mate. Now let's fire it up. One-handed. Here's a tip for all new pipe smokers or people who are thinking of taking to the pipe and possibly or who are intimidated by all these quite extravagant pipes that you'll see on YouTube and eBay. You don't have to go for that amount of cost to get something that looks, you know, pretty decent. Anyway, this really isn't about this pipe. This is about these things. I'll try and make this as brief because it's quite a long story, so I won't go into it too much. About a year ago, I was travelling to my girlfriend's house cross country. This is one reason again why the vehicle I had at the time was something quite funny considering the size of me. I mean, I'm a 6'3" and a fairly big bloke, and if you saw the car I used to own, you'd say, how did you get in that? Because if you saw the film, is it Police Academy? You've got the big black guy, Hightower, who gets in that small car and he basically sits in the back seats, takes the front seats out. It sort of looked like that. The car I used to have was this one. At the time, you know, it came up for grabs, very, very cheap. I needed a car, hadn't got a lot of money. My friend, it was his girlfriend, his ex-girlfriend, who was selling this. It didn't look like that at the time. I mean, that was my handiwork to make it look like that. It was a small, compact car. And what we've got here is a Renault 5. It's a 1400 engine. It's very, very nippy. But like I say, if you saw me getting it, you'd say, how the heck did you get in that? Not my first choice of vehicle. In the past, I have been known to owning some wild cars. When times were different, had a different job, petrol was cheap in this country, Torino, Camaros, Transams, all sorts of crazy cars. That's just a few of them I used to own, but they were quite cheap enough to buy in this country. And they sort of suited my size, but as time went on and circumstances change, you know, it's the old cliche, hate using it but I'm going to use it, and needs must, so I end up with this. But it served its purpose very well. But what I didn't consider is its survival in an accident, and that leads me to the close call. So basically, I'm on the way to my girlfriend's house, going cross-country route. And it was a weekend. It was Saturday night, around about 8 o'clock. It was dark and wet. And the route to my girlfriend's house, across the country from here, you go through a series of quite winding, bendy roads. As you pass some farmhouses and some farm buildings on the right-hand side, you come to a bend. I've took this bend many times. It is overshadowed on the road, as you can see here, by this big tree, this big sort of bush. Anyway, this particular night, I was on dipped headlights, and as I went around the corner, I met another vehicle on the same side as me. And what it was, to cut a long story short, they were overtaking another car at that crucial point. So basically, at the split second, I was faced head on with this vehicle. I had two choices. I either swerve or go straight into it. So I swerved. So imagine that's my vehicle as I approach the bend, and round here, as we turn around the bend, the other vehicle was basically where this red marker is here, and I was around about here. And that is the point of impact where I swerve to avoid a head-on collision. Basically, there was a crunch, and then a stop, and then a skid. The car that hit me pulled up just over to my right-hand side. The car that overtook was stationed here, and I was in a state of shock. Banged my head against the pillar of the car here. But other than that, no injury at all, which I was very lucky. I was pretty good at swerving out the way there, because if not, the alternative was head-on, and who knows? I might not be here now talking to you about it. But when I glanced over my shoulder to look at the vehicle that had impacted with me, I couldn't believe my eyes. And this is the best bit. It was a police car. No flashing lights, no sirens, lights on, because it was obviously nighttime, but it was a cop car. And I couldn't believe it. There's a link to this, really, to smoking. Not pipes, but something else. Obviously, next thing you know, two police officers got out of the car. One did. Tall, young guy, very, very young, came over to me and says, "Are you okay?" I said, "Well, you know, I am, but I think the car's not very well." Then I looked at this guy, at this copper, and I thought, "I know you." And he said, "I know you." I said, "Well, where do I know you from?" And he says, "Well, I don't know you in a way that, you know, I've arrested you." I said, "Well, no, you don't. I know you from somewhere else." To cut a long story short, the young policeman that was talking to me, I had bought some cigars off him not that many weeks ago from my local car boot sale, which was amazing. Anyway, one of those weird moments where, you know, you're in this situation and something goes off on a tangent and you think, what is all this about? But the other guy in the car, the driver, he got out of the car and he was bewildered. You could tell by his face that he'd made a big mistake. And I just thought, wow, this is unreal. I got my mobile phone, phoned my girlfriend. She cried because at the time it's a shock of, you know, I said, "I'm okay, there's no damage, there's no injuries whatsoever." But it could have been so much worse. I would say that was pretty much a close call. And a bit of debris of my car at the curb. Went back a few days later to take some photographs. This is a mock-up of what happened. That would be me. This is the police car overtaking the car here. which was about to pass me. So this is the offending vehicle. Bang. And I just went whoop down here. So that's how it looked before the accident. And that's how it was afterwards. It was completely wrote off. As you can see, if I hadn't have swerved, the collision would have been here and buff me. So that's my close call. Pretty close. I have made a sort of like a conscious effort not to buy a small car again. Very economical indeed, but not very good on impact. I mean, yes, I would like to own something like this again. But at 8 to the gallon in this country, it's not good. I wouldn't even get to Asda. So, there you go. Close call for 80's pipes. Mario Grandi. Keep them smoking. See you soon.